you ever seen a time lapse of the sun? Does it look like the earth is rotating backwards and the sun is still? Or does it look like our sun is simply moving across our sky, traveling away from your perspective? Again, but with some inversion, you can clearly see the sun not only decreasing its size, but heading towards its next destination with a slight turn before it disappears from your line of sight. While Google would make sure when you type in flat earth that nothing like this would ever pop up, many agree the science regarding our sun is far from settled.
We're told that the sun is a massive ball of burning gas 93 million miles away. But if that were true, then all the light that arrives here would be parallel because it's so far away. And it has to be parallel because one of the most often cited supposed globe proofs is Eratosthenes' experiment between Alexandria and Syene, by which he calculated the size of the Earth. For that calculation to be accurate, the light must come down parallel. The only problem is that that's not what we see. If you go out on a sunny day with broken cloud, what you'll see is that light comes down at angles, diverging angles. And that means that we can follow those light rays back to the source and triangulate the sun's height above the Earth, proving that the sun isn't millions of miles away. But we can also perform physical experiments that prove that these crepuscular rays, as they're called, can only be recreated with a light source that is small and close.
It doesn't take a genius to understand that the further the light source goes up, the more the sun rays would spread out and become parallel. The reason you'd even think that the sun...
If the Earth was flat, wouldn't it be sunny all the time? Have they ever even thought about it?
Well, if you'd let me finish, the reason you'd even think the sun would be visible from anywhere on Earth is because of the images they have shown you. No one promoting this bull stands for truth. You can keep believing in your fantasy gas ball 93 million miles away.
You can keep believing in your fantasy gas ball.
While we keep experimenting to try and figure out what the sun actually is and how close it could be. With a local hotspot, it should be easy to comprehend that the sun is small and close to you.
To put that in perspective, imagine a table 2 meters wide in a completely dark room. And you're holding a small but very bright light bulb, 3.4 millimeters across. And you were holding it about 31 centimeters above the table. What you'd see is a circular pool of light directly on the table, you know, beneath the light bulb. But on the other side of the table, it would be in darkness. Now, it seems to our mind that if you were on the other side of the table, you would see the light because it's, you know, above the table. But that's not true because on that part of the table, it's in darkness, meaning that the light isn't physically reaching that part of the tabletop.
Your senses are correct.
We're also told that the sun sets because as the Earth rotates us away from the sun, it's actually obscured by the physical curvature of the Earth. That's not what we see.
What we see is a local sun that is taking its local light with it. What happened to the horizon glowing across half of the world? Most sunsets are already fading through pollution, dander, chemtrails, and fog. Plus, refraction will always make the sun seem like it's going down, as well as your perspective.
It would appear to sink down in your field of view. That's perspective. The further away you get from it, the lower it will appear. It doesn't physically change its height. It just appears that way to your eyes until eventually it will disappear behind the horizon formed by your eye's vanishing point. Your eye has an angular resolution of 0.2 degrees. And anything at that height will disappear beyond the limit of your sight. Many times we can see time-lapse footage of the sun that shows it getting smaller as it moves away from us. Now, that's not always the case. Since the sun is travelling around the North Pole, the closer you are to the north, the less you'll see the size change. But from locations beyond the equator, you'll absolutely see the sun's size change. And that could never ever happen if the sun was 93 million miles away. You wouldn't see the sun change at all.
Our eyes cannot see farther than what they were designed to see. But that is no reason to keep them closed.
There's also an effect that occurs under certain conditions called atmospheric lensing, where the sheer amount of atmosphere, as well as the rain between you and the sun, acts like a lens and a prism, magnifying it greatly, which leads to another observational proof that the sun setting is an optical effect. At such times, when the sun is setting over the sea, and it seems as though it's half hidden by the horizon, then you can zoom in with a high-powered zoom camera and see that it's actually still above the horizon. It's just an optical illusion.
Pay attention to the sun rays here. This alone proves our local sun, and so do these shadows. So what about the moon? We all witness the moon only illuminating the local clouds around it. That is because it is also a local light, but one with opposite effects from the sun. As we can all agree, shade from the sun is cooler than direct sunlight. But did you know, the moon's shade is actually warmer than direct moonlight? The moon produces cold light, something the science priests must have forgotten to teach us all about in school. Not only that, but at times, we can see stars through the moon, proving it is not some solid rock 238,900 miles away. In the 60s, true science regarding the moon was the shadow banned topic of its era.
I consider myself to be an ordinary, humble person who wants to serve mankind with what man has striven for from the beginning of consciousness, with truth and understanding of the world.
Well, now, one thing, you have a theory about the moon, and we expect to be able to get observable facts about the moon fairly soon. What is your theory?
Well, it is by now rather more than a theory. 10 or 11 years ago, I stated to various scientists that the moon is not a piece of rock, but it is a plasma, cosmic plasma. Gravitational theories are out, and a new concept of the cosmos and of its laws has to be evolved. This fact will eventually be confirmed. I made certain predictions which were already confirmed in 1958, and the situation now is coming close to a complete confirmation.
What will be the result if you are proved to be correct in your theories?
The result will be profound and decisive. Because if the moon is a plasma, no man will ever land on it.
The Americans and Russians are thinking of landing men on it.
Oh, well, that will never happen.
People actually...